You're watching the fastest growing local news station. This is WPBF 25 News at 11.
The big chill continues in South Florida as you bundle up in bed. The temperatures continue to drop. Tonight, some areas could get near freezing. Good evening. I'm Tiffany Kenny. Thank you for joining us. We have live team coverage of tonight's big story. Ted White is in West Palm Beach with how folks are braving the cold. But we begin with Mike Lyons. He is outside our studios with a look at just how cold it will get. And Mike, I'm guessing right about now you're pretty miserable.
I'm not happy. That's for sure. And I know a lot of other people are not too happy either, Tiffany, because this weather is unprecedented here in South Florida. Not just cold. Very cold with freeze warnings in effect, but also the fact that this cold spell, it's going to stick around. Not just tonight, not just tomorrow night. How about for the rest of this week, a brief warm up on Thursday and Friday, and then we're going to do it all over again next week. Let's begin with a look at the advisories. Many of us under a freeze warning tonight. By the way, I'm looking at my iTouch phone here, and temperatures outside our studios in the mid-range of the 40s right now. But freeze warnings are in effect for just about all of South Florida. The exception, the eastern part of Palm Beach County. If you live east of the Turnpike, you are not under the freeze warnings, but temperatures are still going to be very, very cold. Wind chills as well. We've got a wind chill advisory in effect for the region tomorrow morning. Temperatures in the 20s. Let's get specific and show you your town and the predicted low temperature on Tuesday morning. We're expecting temperatures at or below freezing in many locations for at least 1, maybe 2 hours tomorrow morning. And the coldest time will be between 4 a.m. and 8 a.m. After that, temperatures should rebound a bit. We'll see highs tomorrow afternoon in the upper 50s, but tomorrow night will be even colder. In fact, I expect tomorrow night just about all of us will see freezing temperatures. Now, for most of us, it's kind of a nuisance, this cold weather. It's kind of something we don't care for. But for some, it can be downright dangerous. Our live team coverage continues now. Ted White live at a shelter in West Palm Beach. Ted?
Mike, for many people who do not have a place to call home, this is the place to be. Inside this church, it is a place to worship and a place where many people can worship for a while and lay their heads. As the temperatures dip close to freezing Monday night, Annie Williams is thankful she and her two boys, ages 9 and 11, will have a warm place to rest their heads.
If it wasn't for Westgate, I would actually be on the streets. So it's a blessing for me and my children, and I just thank God for it.
Williams lost her job at Walmart after she became sick and spent time in the hospital. It wasn't long before they couldn't afford to pay rent and had to move out of their apartment. But Williams is not one to complain.
I've been freezing, so I know it's like hard for those that don't have anywhere to go.
On this night, the Westgate Tabernacle gets close to a full house.
We have been taking a bed. We're not going to turn anyone away with the cold weather. It doesn't matter to us who it is or where they're coming from. They need a place to stay. They need to get in and out of that weather.
Sylvia Negley is senior pastor at Westgate. She says they've been getting donations of food and clothing, but not much else.
Finances aren't coming in. And so we're having to cut back on a lot of things. Our showers we do every other day because that helps us with the water. The electricity, we make sure that the lights are out in the church throughout the day.
What they do have for now is a church full of people who will not have to spend the night shivering in the cold. Again, the many people who are inside the Westgate Tabernacle will have a warm place to stay tonight. And the face of homelessness is ever so changing. It's not uncommon for them to get people who have all of their belongings packed in their clothes and packed in their cars, rather, because they have lost their homes to foreclosure and they have perhaps lost a job within their families. We're live at West Palm Beach. Ted White, WPBF 25 News.